Yeah, I just, it pains me to no end that we're still doing this to people, right? That we're still dividing secular and sacred, which when if you look anywhere in the scriptures, it's so hard to do that or to see where that happened. Jesus worked for 30 years, he preached for 3. I mean, that's 1/10 of his life that he actually preached for. He was a carpenter until he was age 30. You know, he probably began that apprenticeship around 13, 14 years old. So, I mean, he lived the most of his life was doing work. Now, I wish we had stories about him then so we could see, because it probably would totally change the paradigm. But, so, you know, it's true of, I think it's more true of Western churches, number one. And I think it is more true in certain circles and spaces. And I am very familiar with that sort of guilt of what do I do? So here's what I did. About 7 or 8 years ago, I said, you know what? I need to know that I can stand before the Lord and share with him, here's my theology of what I did in life. Here is why I thought I could practice marketing and advertising and work in media. And so I did this basic sort of framework that we talk about a lot in Faith at Work, is not just thinking about the gospel story as the fall and redemption, but really thinking about the whole story of the Bible, the whole narrative that's being told by God of creation. We were given a creation and cultural mandate in the book of Genesis. We were told to create, to go out and subdue the earth. We were told to tend to the garden. The word there is this word that indicates culture and cultivation and tending. And so there's a picture there of God giving us creation and asking us to go make something of it. And so I just basically went through and I sort of delineated, here's all the elements of what I do, whether it's branding or communication, or advertising, persuasive communication, communication other ways, and the issue of competition. And so I just walked through everything that I saw. I went to the Bible and I said, let me work through all of these things and how can I build out a theology of work for myself so I could stand before the Lord and say, this is why I did what I did. Now I might have understood life wrong, I might have interpreted the Bible wrong, and I'm sorry, but this is the work that I did and what good I think came out of it in the end. And so I don't know any other way to wrestle through that tension other than do you feel called to it? If you feel called to it, I would go find somebody who has a theology of it built, or I would wrestle through and do the work yourself. And once I've done that, it's been, I feel as called as my pastor as if I were a missionary, because I realize what we're doing is making the world better, and I understand the things I will do and the things that I won't do in terms of, is this redeeming and is this restoring something that's broken? So.